Hi, I'm Lainey Melnick with Dream Vacations. This week, here I am on Royal Caribbean Allure of the Seas out of Galveston. Excited that we got an amazing Oasis class ship out of Galveston. It's about time. Texas is big and Allure is big enough for us. So I'm super excited and I can't wait to show you around the ship because you're gonna love it. And it's just a short drive. It took us 3 to 4 hours today from Austin. Simple, easy parking at the new terminal that's gorgeous and beautiful. So this is a really easy vacation than to go to the Caribbean for a few days from Texas. Here we are at Galveston at the new Royal Caribbean Terminal. And you can see the beautiful Allure of the Seas right behind me. This is gorgeous. Follow me and let me show you all around this amazing ship. So this is the new Royal Caribbean Terminal 10. Love it. Brand new, sparkling, lots of space. You can take a shuttle bus over from the parking lot or walk over. The north parking lot is closer than the south. Terminal 10, Royal Caribbean's amazing. I recommend you do mobile check-in for sure before you get to the port.
Straight down for check-in.
Thank you.
Are you fully vaccinated?
I am, yes, of course.
All right, do you have the booster?
I do, yes.
Are you pregnant?
No.
Are you feeling good today? Are you feeling okay?
I feel so good.
Awesome.
Fabulous.
Good to hear. May I see your passport, please?
That's a good picture.
I know, right?
Wait a minute, look at how terrible my passport fit
up. That's crazy. Either way, you look good.
Oh, thank you.
I love checking.
All right, you are safe.
Thank you.
You're going to head on to the handy, just follow the crew.
Okay.
And enjoy.
Thank you very much. So now it's time for security.
Hey, super easy security.
And you have to get your sea pass checked before you can go all aboard. All set! Woohoo!
Texas is really not this Texan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome on board the Allure of the Seas, Royal Caribbean.
I love it so far. I love it. They know that I need to know what day it is in Royal Caribbean. It is Wednesday. I had no idea, actually. Okay, they're pretty good in their elevator descriptions. We're on deck 11 and we go towards the starboard side, Diamond Club Library State Rooms. I'm in 601. I think I've ever seen this before. So there's a community bulletin board, which tells you some things to go do.
Oh, and you can put little notes up for people.
cool. Hey, it looks like I'm forward 601.
Welcome on board. I got my keys here.
And yes, I packed in a carry-on for two trips in a row because I'm going to conference after this on Norwegian Encore. All set.
Cabin 601 is a Central Park balcony. So it's actually an inside balcony. I'll show you in a second what that means. I already spilled my champagne all over me. So this is the bathroom. I'm gonna have to ask for some actual shampoo and conditioner because I can't do that. They're good about bringing it if you ask. Some storage here. And storage under. It's kind of a tight little squeeze in here. The towels are not as nice as what I had on Celebrity. This is a connecting cabin. All right, let's see what goodies they gave me. All right, there's magazines. Looks like I have a safety video going. So they give me some plugs here, some more storage by the desk. There is a hair dryer and the fridge. It's a regular refrigerator, it's not a freezer. Oops. So you have a closet and then you have some shelves and of course the safe. Am I missing something here? You put your suitcase under the bed after you unpack. So they have a master switch. It looks like the cruise lines are moving away from having that card to turn on and off the electric, which I hate. So I'm glad they're doing away with that. And let me show you now the balcony. Open, you switch up, and then pull. So an inside balcony actually overlooks the interior portions of the ship. We are over Central Park here, which is where a lot of the specialty restaurants are, some entertainment. You can look right at the balconies across from us. I see a store I want to go to. So between the balconies, you have these separators. And some of the balconies do open if you'd like to connect with the cabin next to you. Then you can unhook these and be able to see next door or walk next door. So with Central Park, I don't have a view of the ocean from the inside. Some of the cabins do have both the ocean and the interior of the ship. So my balcony has room for two chairs and a table, which is really nice and roomy. Perfect for doing my coffee later. So welcome to the Allure of the Seas. Okay, so I'm unpacked and I can already see some issues. So there are outlets over here, but nothing by the bed. I don't have any place to plug in even USB over here that I can see. Maybe I'm missing it. There's not a whole lot of space. I don't like the drawers being over by the desk instead of in my changing area here. So I put everything in these shelves. And then there's a lot of these hanging kind of hangers, which I don't use really much. Then on the other side, see, you have to close the safe or it gets in the way. So you put in a code and then it closes. So then you can open your closet. I packed for two vacations, so I have a lot of clothes, but still I'm alone here. So the only place that you can hang all the way long is on the left there, if you have this down. I don't have to have this down though. So I think what I'm gonna do is put that back up. You just slide it back that way. Okay, now all of my dresses can hang long, which I like. So anyway, there's not a whole lot of space for two people. And then after you unpack your suitcase, you slide it under your bed. But I have no way to plug in my CPAP yet. I'm gonna ask my steward to please give me a cord. And after I watch my safety video, I am gonna go get some lunch. It's 1 o'clock. I'm gonna go grab some lunch before I show you around the ship and take off my new cowboy hat.
So this is where my cabin is, 11601. So it's equal distance between the forward and the aft elevators. Diamond Club is here on deck 11. There's a private function, I'll show you later.
So I love how they decorate outside the elevators. This is the library. If you're looking for a nice quiet place to read a book, perfect. I am gonna go down to 8, where Central Park is, and that has Park Cafe, one of my favorite places to eat lunch.
Slow them down.
8. All right, so I am going to go to Central Park. Dazzles is also here. Central Park is one of the prettiest areas on the ship. If you followed my other videos from Royal Caribbean, I have quite a few of them. You'll see a lot of the Central Park. I wonder if Chop's Grill is open for lunch today. Tastings.
And this crispy goat cheese.
Goat cheese, and what's the other?
Tuna tartare.
Tuna. I definitely will have that. Thank you.
Tuna tartare. Together with avocado.
So I love Chop's Grill. It's a great steak restaurant. Delicious. It also had pork belly. Ooh, that's going to be really hard to eat with this fork. This is delicious. Pork belly, really yummy. Okay, last sample, this is the shrimp cocktail. Maybe it's because I'm really hungry, but it's all really good. I love Chops, but it is an additional charge. It's not a complimentary restaurant. All right, so this is 150 Central Park, another really fabulous restaurant that has great steaks. Let's see what they're giving today.
Oh, we have vegetable pork belly and scallop, chickpeas, and also the roasted organic beet salad with creamy goat cheese.
That's excellent.
All right. Now, at Central Park 150, this is like a step up. More fine dining, beautiful. I love Central Park 150. So it's a little different the way they make it here. This is delicious also, really, really yummy. I've had dinner here before, highly recommend Central Park 150, really good. Now this is the scallop, it's really yummy. So, I don't like scallops as much as I like.
They're about 6 hours old.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you very much.
Delicious. So you can see my cabin's like right up there. Oh, Giovanni's also has tastings today. It's Italian. Hi. What have you got today?
We have the prosciutto, madam, with pepperberries, cherry tomatoes, seafood parmesan cheese, and stick bread.
Sounds delicious. Thank you. So Giovanni's table is fabulous Italian. I love prosciutto, so this should be delicious. So this also is a specialty restaurant, so there are additional charges. I love Park Cafe. They have a fabulous
sandwich that I always get here. It's called the Kummelreck. Kummelreck? That's the sandwich I always get. Hi, can I order your Kummelreck? How do you say that? Kummelreck.
So it's originally from Buffalo.
Buffalo,
yeah.
Okay.
And, from the western of America.
All right. Tell me everything you're doing.
So it's with roast beef.
Roast beef, okay.
Roast beef and with some dressing like oju and spicy mustard, horseradish mayonnaise. Mm,
okay, sounds good. Give me everything.
All right, which dressing was that?
All of it. Just a little of everything.
Okay.
But I like a wet bun, like the au jus. It's like a cooking show, you guys.
Welcome to Five Cafe.
Thank you.
Two. Podcast.
Thank you.
All right, good.
Perfect. I'm glad I got it fresh this time. It's beautiful. It's really big. This is one of my most favorite things to do for complimentary lunch. So you don't have to pay extra to get this beautiful roast beef sandwich. And lots of people don't know about this place. So you know all my secrets. Park Cafe, Central Park. I got a Zumi has samples for me. What have you got?
We have some snow crab California roll.
Okay, what's this one?
Spicy tuna roll. Mm,
that's me. Thank
spicy.
You. Yummy.
Delicious.
Mm. Yummy,
yummy. You tell them. Yummy, yummy.
So good. So Izumi is really good, but it's not like sushi when you eat sushi at home, you know, with the rolls and the sushi, you know, it's different, but it was good. You know. So I'm not allowed to take videos usually of the tables when people are in here. But there are tables, slots, all sorts of things you can do in the casino. And there's the art gallery, paintings all over. All right, it looks like I found my muster.
Did you watch the safety video? Do you know approximately what to do in case of emergency? So approximately know what to do in case of emergency. If you ever hear 7-1-1 short blast, this is the place where you need to be. It's very important. Studio B, ice skating show. That's pretty much it. You did the safety duty.
Okay.
You're doing a good job.
Sounds good. Thank you. All right. I'm with Sherry. So of course she's making me go here.
Hi. Here we go. Take us out, Cosmo.
So when you check your bags, they just leave them out here outside your rooms. So what's annoying about like having a lanyard with your key here is you can't just swipe it. You have to actually take your key out and put it in the lock like this.
Please make it easy to get your break. And we love Peter here is the United Galveston channel. And it's great to have you here in the Southern House of Hospitality in Galveston, Texas. And I'll update you tomorrow at noon as we move along down through the Gulf. Y'all have a nice evening.
Cheers.
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 I don't know where we're going
today. Okay, so elevator.
It is Wednesday.
I love glass elevators. And they've got these really pretty like dresses.
We are going to Cosmo.
Yeah, we're
kind of sorry.
Time figuring out what kind of food.
Yeah, yeah, I like it.
Yeah, that's the order.
That's the one that was
snuggy.
There's Central Park, so these must be our cabins. Pool deck. It is sailaway. So as with all cruise ships, if you're in diapers, you cannot go in a pool.
Okay,
thank
man.
You.
Right?
Oh, Texas! Okay. Woohoo! Lone Star State! They have these splash zones, and that way kids who have diapers can get wet and have fun. Now these windows open, but they're up high. I'm leading my entourage. They're not very, very good at following. This is where you get your towel checkout. Very easy. Seven. That's a good idea. Hey, hi.
Filming. FaceTiming.
Oh, no, I'm not. And that's Sherry, that's there, and we're all no reserving deck chairs. Here is the mast bar. More drinking, of course. I guess I should have worn my Royal Caribbean and cowboy hat.
And get ready to party as we celebrate in a few more minutes right here. If you are ready, make some noise! Oh yeah, party people, welcome aboard! Is right here sailing out of Galveston, because what do they say about Texas?
Texas is right here. Texas.
Allure is one of the biggest ships of Royal Caribbean. Of course, first time sailing away from Galveston, we are very happy. Are you excited? All right. Well, this is your sail away party. As we sail away from Galveston, everybody say goodbye, Galveston. Hello, vacation! And it got it like this. Are those Texas nice? Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
We left. We left Galveston. Sail away is always fun, but now the sun's going down and you have to go get ready for dinner so fast because we have 6 o'clock main dining here. If you have specialty reservations, you can go ahead and just choose your time that you want. Otherwise, you're kind of stuck with late or early dining. I mean, there's always the buffet if you want to do the buffet, but I don't like buffets.
There's a way to sail away that I like, the hot tub.
So this is the solarium. It is the adults area, the adults only area. It's very loud in here. Usually it's very quiet in here. That's the solarium pool. It's a little different from the other ships. Also a hot tub in here, and there's a cafe as well. Hot tubs on both sides. Beautiful views out. Now we're at the main pool deck. See the difference in the main pool from the Celebrity Beyond that I just got off of and the Royal Caribbean Allure. It's really similar. Celebrity's just a little longer. Remember, this is a very large ship. There's a lot of people on board. In the hot tubs. All the impressive media from travel. I'll see you later. Okay, and then this is the other pool. So there's like dueling pools on this ship. So on this side, you've got this beautiful pool with this beautiful lifeguard. And then on the other side, there's the other one. Because in the middle, you have the Central Park, where my cabin overlooks. This is the hot tub that I was showing you from above. I'm trying not to invade their privacy by showing you everybody in it. But it's pretty awesome view. Pretty beautiful hot tub. And then this is the downstairs for the solarium, which is the adults only area. And they have the Samba Grill here, Brazilian Steakhouse. This is the solarium area downstairs. I was upstairs before. Nice group socializing areas down here and little tables for two if you'd like. This is the solarium pool. It looks like it's very unpopular compared to the hot tubs. Let me see why. Oh, it's freezing. That's why. It's very chilly. Then this is the other hot tub on the other side. Another one with a great view. Look at that hidden sun deck. You go down to 14. Oh, and then all the way to the front. This is a fabulous ship for all generations. Okay, so the sun deck is out here. This little hidden sun deck that's all the way forward. Make crazy hair. Let me figure out where my hair is not going to be crazy. Oh, and look, there's a helipad. Nice. We do have these navigation little screens. It's important when you're trying to find your room that you know if you're starboard or port, and that way it makes it really easy to know which way to go. Some ships are odd and even. This one is not.
So I am starboard. I have to keep remembering I'm starboard. The other key is, are you forward or after midship? And I am midship. I'm between forward and aft right now. I am, I need to go to the left. Or no, that's my right. I have to go right. Oh, where I am. Okay, ask for an extension cord so I could get my CPAP plugged in, but there is a plug under the bed. Denny?
Denny, yes.
Is my stateroom attendant, yes. And he is being very sweet to plug in my CPAP for me.
Okay.
And you'll bring me a shampoo and conditioner. Okay.
And also just quick remind you about the master suite, please.
Yeah, can you explain? Because I have my computer plugged in. So
yeah,
if...
this one is the master suite for your room.
Uh-huh.
This one, just leave it on like this because it's control your AC, your light, your everything.
Okay,
your
master stays on.
Yeah.
And then these go off.
And also the balcony door handle, make sure facing down.
Yes.
Yeah, and please help me with the magnet sign also.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, when you're out the room, please pressing this one. When you're out, or when you're sleeping time, or when you're prep for time, please put this one aside.
Okay, perfect.
All right. Anything else, maybe?
So these switches aren't going to turn off my desk.
Yeah, this one only.
Okay.
This one, just leave it on like this. Just leave it alone like this.
Okay.
This one is control your ceiling light. This one for picture frame. This
one. Oh, okay.
Okay. And this one for your bathroom.
Oh, okay. Right.
And there is the small switch here to control your bedside light.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Got it. And you do have shampoo and conditioner separate.
Sure, sure.
You do. Okay.
I'm gonna give you the amenities like a small bottle.
Okay.
Or you wanna complete like the shampoo, lotion, and shower gel?
Well, I'd love everything if you have it.
Okay, I'm gonna.
Because I use the shower gel too.
Sure. So what time are you gonna go in for dinner?
At 6. So yeah,
don't forget put the sign for me so I can come back when you're.
So I'm not gonna shower now then.
Okay.
I'll wait. And I don't get a robe in this room, correct?
It's a by request.
By request?
Yes. The
request the robe.
By
may I have a robe, please?
Sure, no problem.
Okay. Anything else I should request?
Bathroom? Ice?
I don't need ice.
No.
No.
Okay.
Is that it? What about water?
Water is from the room service or in the minibar. You can order. There is the menu bar here.
Oh, okay.
Mini bar menu here.
Okay, but that costs money?
Or? Yeah, there is cost money here.
Okay.
And the you can get it upstairs also, the water.
Oh, okay.
Any dining.
I'm just bringing it home. Okay, bring it home.
All right.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Enjoy your vacation, Madam Lainey.
The other thing to remember when you're in an inside balcony is you have to close your shades when you're getting dressed and undressed, or everybody's going to be seeing you getting dressed and undressed. As you could see when we were looking down at Central Park, there's two different areas that have the Central Park views. We are right across from Picture This Portrait Studio, so that helps me try to figure out where I am. There's a restaurant under me. I'm really curious where I am. There's Coach that way. Oh, look, he's there. Oh my God, wait. There's. Okay, this is the complimentary dining room, and we got a beautiful big table for 10. Thank you. Oops. So again, classics will be on the menu every day, and they change out everything above. I'm going to eat the same exact thing I had on Celebrity. Well, compare. Look at this soft, beautiful piece of bread. I love soft bread. I'm so happy. Royal, you gave me soft bread. Thank you. So there are three decks of the dining area, but it's all the same, even though each of the restaurants has a different name. My escargot. Delicious. You know, I'm a French girl. They have to do escargot right. Two things. They did not serve it with bread. They did not give me a little escargot fork. So, two things that did not.
I'm using a regular fork.
Oh.
Are you really French?
I wouldn't.
Good?
This is so much better than the one I had at Celebrity.
Right.
Really good.
Look at this gorgeous French onion soup. Oh my God, it is done absolutely perfectly. Much better than my last one. It looks really hot. So the escargot was lukewarm.
Yeah.
So
there was a little bit in the quality presentation that was lacking, but it was delicious. But they made this French onion soup exactly like I like it. I really like the flavor. I love the cheese, the way it's crusted. I think this is a good French onion soup.
That's why they're so delicious.
I ordered the filet from Chop's Grill, which is an extra charge.
Let's see how they cooked it. So I asked for rare. Very important to me that I have a good rare piece of meat. Pretty good. I like it.
Wow, good.
Oh, another one.
Oh my! So jealous. I'm so jealous.
Fabulous. So good. I'm so glad I did this. The hazelnut chocolate with whipped cream on the side. This looks good.
It's from an Ellicott one in Missouri City. So we're really
happy. So it's
happy.
Not mushy like I thought.
Otherwise, I would treat
Sherry's not very hungry.
I'm like, why is it worth it?
Is that fruit?
It's okay.
Awesome.
Especially the women of Texas.
I don't love it.
How many times can you beat yourself up?
But it's good. Chocolate.
But you still
can order the specialty dining stuff in the restaurant. They bring you a bill, and I add a tip. So take care of your waiters. They're looking for like a little bag. There are designer bag stores like Kate Spade and other. I do sell lanyards here, so if you would like a lanyard to carry your card around, Spade. You can ride the carousel, you can get a hot dog, you can go to the Zoltar machine like in Big. Oh, you can go to other stores here and ride the carousel and you can get some ice cream. Yeah, Johnny Rockets is in here. Are you doing this tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll come back when I have some pants on. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. So the secret about Johnny Rockets is that they have an awesome breakfast every day. You can come here and they'll cook you like a diner breakfast. Nobody ever knows about it. So we're checking out another store. It's aboard their tequila taqueria, and here's the awesome Johnny Rockets. I love Royal Caribbean at night. Like the boardwalk area at night is just so fun and so awesome. Favorite show. It's the Aqua Theater show. There's the rock wall. Okay, so there are no seats in here. As you can see, everything is taken. So I'm going up here on the side of the rock wall. And this is the secret. Excuse me. Woo. The secret staircase. So this is my secret. We have a secret area up here nobody knows about, but select view. And look at this view.
Thank you. Show at Amber Theater. There's a line for drinks. Plenty of space. Okay. My Bailey's. Good dessert.
You guys excited to be on the Allure of the Seas? Yeah. My name's Corey. I do have the privilege to be your cruise director. Everyone say, hey, Corey!
Hey, Corey!
Who's from Texas? We're so excited to be here out of Galveston, Texas, of course, being the largest cruise ship to ever sail out of Galveston. It's just such an honor to be here. Very excited. We know you guys are going to have a great cruise vacation. Our incredible headliner performer tonight, ladies and gentlemen, comes all the way from Las Vegas. He's one of Royal Caribbean's favorites, and he is known as the ultimate entertainer and full of energy. So, ladies and gentlemen, get ready for showtime.
Are you ready to have a party tonight?
Bye-bye.
Jazz on four is jazz, and then blaze is the nightclub. Oh, silent disco. I guess I didn't get enough silent disco last night.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. happens.
Oh my God! They don't give you free waters in the rooms here. So before you leave, go to a bar and get a water bottle. So they actually give me a plastic bottle here.
They brought me a robe, like I asked. It's a terry robe, still comfy. I can't wait to go to sleep, but I need to work.
And it's time for Vicky Freed, one of my most favorite people in the world.
Oh, they're taking care of us. Vicky always takes care of us.
Thank you. Good morning from Royal Caribbean Allure of the Seas. This morning, Vicky Freed is going to be giving us her fabulous motivational talk. And I can't wait to see my old friend.
Good morning.
Fabulous friend, my wonderful inspiration.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
They are quite literally the best in the world for the unbelievable Mosaic.
Say that we kind of share common ground in that, because we're entertainers, and in the travel industry, I think those might have been the two industries hit hardest, you know, and I know that it was a very dark time. Things changed overnight for us, right? But we weathered that storm, didn't we? Because here we are, we're back, and in a lot of ways, I think it's even going to be better for us, because we learned a lot, and we made that transformation, we made the transition, and here we are. And I think I can speak for all of us when I say, it feels really good to be back out here doing what we love to do.
Yeah!
Absolutely. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here this morning. We're happy you're here. We're happy to be here for you. We're going to do this next song, and then we're going to take off. But we just wanted to dedicate this to all of you out there. And once again, thanks for being here with us.
Do you ever feel like a pulse? Drifting through the wind, morning has spun again. Do you ever feel so painful? Like a house of cards, one blow from cave to wind.
captain. Would you like a captain? Yeah. Make sure I say captain! James, my ball!
Woo!
I think we need a hotel director. Where's Johan? Hi, captain. Good to see you. Good morning. Johan, one of the best in the business. I think we need an SVP of hotel operations, the one and only Sean Tracy. There you are! Woo! Well, you're not getting more than that, ladies and gentlemen.
During the last 2.5 years, but we're no longer calling it the pandemic, we're calling it the pause. And now we are back in business.
Your support and all the great sales you bring us, that we're able to build beautiful terminals in Galveston and bring this big, beautiful ship to Texas. So we really appreciate your partnership. And now we haven't stopped making perfect day more perfecter. We've already announced we are underway having an adults-only beach, Hideaway Beach. An amazing adult space. There'll be more cabanas. There'll be lots of beautiful things. I'm staring at Jay. Is everything public, Jay? None of it's public yet. Okay. It's an amazing experience. Forget what I just said.
Tomorrow is Veterans Day. No. And I want to say thank you to all the service men and women and the family members who have served men and women. You know, this is a tricky time in our country and in our world. And when we have people that are committed to fighting for our freedom, I think we have to show gratitude and appreciate everybody's effort. And so I want to honor our military and the families that support our military. It is so moving for all of us as we are.
I'm going to speak actually on behalf of the entire officers and crew on board. First of all, I want to say thank you. Thank you for welcoming us in this beautiful port of Galveston. As well, I want to say thank you to Galveston and to our career and give us this wonderful new terminal here. We're very proud to be here. And everybody yesterday, all the crew members, we went out, they looked at this, and we are so proud to be here. It looks fantastic. When somebody mentioned it took only 50 minutes to get to the curbside and on the ship. We will make it 12 minutes next time. And as well, I want to say thank you to all of you, what you do for us every single day to fill up your ships and to keep us in business. And someone mentioned of you, 2 years of pause was hard as well, not only for you, but as well for us and for the rest of the world. And we really want to say thank you for everything you do every single day.
Yeah. I'm from Tampa Bay, Florida, and I've been working on it. Galveston for a while on the Liberty of the Seas.
Nice.
So I've had a lot of demo around, a lot of the guests on board. It's great to be here. Good to be in Texas. And I look forward to all the cruises we do out of here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Look forward to seeing you all around.
Yeah.
One more shout out to another best in the industry team. That's the amazing crew on board the Liberty of the Seas.
Yeah.
I just want to say thank you to the captain, the hotel director, the entire team, my leadership team are here with me. They're delivering the best vacations in the world, and we really hope you enjoy the next couple of days. So thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody. We're grateful for your support, and we'll continue to earn your business every single day. Thank you all for being here.
That's correct.
Galveston's awesome. I love Galveston, love Texas, and I look forward to being on the Allure here and do it here too.
All right.
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay, I'm here with my most favorite, most inspirational woman leader in the industry, of course, Vicky Free, Royal Caribbean Sales. And I just want to say thank you for bringing this amazing ship to Galveston. We need it in Texas so bad.
We're very happy to be here in Texas with the Allure of the Seas. It's a beautiful ship and the biggest ship sailing out of Galveston.
Oh, it's awesome.
It's my exact balcony right there.
So Central Park is like walking through a park in the middle of a ship.
There's a lot of noise down here, though it's not quiet. And so Central Park balconies, when you have a balcony, it's going to be noisy on your balcony.
Love Boardwalk. It's so much fun here. I'm going to get on here when I get some pants on. I'm going to try to do this zip line later too. I don't know. This is Pinwheels. I'm so sorry. But I wanted to show you the Candy Beach. Who doesn't want candy when you're on board ship? And nice snacks. All right, cups and scoops. Perfect timing. So this is Ben and Jerry's ice cream and cupcakes now. Now this is an extra charge. It is not complimentary. So a cupcake is $2.50. A giant birthday cupcake is $24.95. Ice cream, a cupcake sundae is $4.25. Banana craze, $5.50. Cups and cones, small is $2.50, medium $3.25, large $4. Waffle cone, 75 cents extra. Toppings, 25 cents and 50 cents extras. Shakes are $4.50. Hey, the dog house, one of my favorite places. Hot dogs.
Everything good.
Yeah, no, they have everything good.
Classic, right?
I want the chicken and apple sausage.
Onions.
Certainly May. Look at that. Yum, May.
Thursday. Today is ship tour day.
Now I can do it. Woo! Oh, I love it when housekeeping comes and cleans and leaves me presents. What did they bring me? Oh my goodness. Oh, these are towel clips. These are actually awesome for being on a cruise to make sure that your towels don't fly away on board when it's so windy. And I got a beautiful Allure beach towel. Thank you so much, Royal.
That's what I was saying.
I cannot pull the...
That's you.
You hear the birds chirping.
Getting this awesome bag from Guess, perfect for my charging block and my camera. All right, we're gonna try Johnny Rockets today for lunch, one of my favorites. Johnny Rockets. Johnny Rockets. So you can get awesome starters, amazing sandwiches and hot dogs, burgers, of course, which is what they're kind of known for. They even have a veggie burger now, and toppings, and of course, shakes and malts, and then desserts. I'm gonna try to get something to show you little bites. Hey, look what he brought me. Thank you.
You can probably enjoy if you have some inside.
Okay.
So add mayo.
Mayo.
Add mayo and add the cheese.
Yeah.
Okay. How about you?
Did you order fries or onion rings yet?
I ordered the chili bacon and the onion ring. Okay. But you can get more if you want.
I want the sweet hot.
Yeah. The fries and the onion ring is unlimited. Like you keep bringing them to fill or not here.
If you want, I will
refill it. Okay. Okay. We might want that. I don't know. Oh! fries. Those are real, just plain fries.
Aww.
So, it's kind of like a Velveeta or American cheese melt, but delicious. Love it. I'm trying the bacon cheese fries. So they're not super crispy fries, they're soft, but I like it that way. My husband would hate this. And the cheese is kind of like a melted Velveeta American kind of cheese. It's very tasty. I like it. You can also get chili on your fries, or you can get them plain. This is my, I can't remember, oh, I think I got the Route 66. And these onion rings are spectacular. A lot to show you. So I like the onion rings that are really thick. I'm not a big fried food person. It might be a little hot. I like it. I love it in the ranch dressing or whatever that dressing is. Really good. So it took a really long time to get our food. I think we sat down at 1:15. It's an hour later we're getting our food. So if you want a quick dinner or lunch or whatever, Johnny Rockets is not quick. Whoops. But if you want a burger, good place to go. Oh, and I got a chili hot dog too, which has not come yet.
Hey, look at this amazing chili cheese dog. Oh my god.
Okay. I'm gonna have a napkin ready. It's good. It's hard to explain. Chili is good. It's not super spicy. I don't know, it's not what I expected. But it's good. Tasty. I really want to try that everything bun at the dog. I don't remember what it's called. The hot dog place that's at the boardwalk. The everything bun looked really good. This is just like a normal bun. But the hot dog is big. It's like, it's not a little hot dog. It's split. It's good. Oh, it's the sexiest
the challenges
man contest.
Have to land hard. Oh, look at Victor right there. Oh, they're sexy and they know it. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
You want to wear something good, maybe a swimsuit or shorts under the... I'm all alone. Nobody wanted to play with me. Right, it's ship tour time. We're starting at 17 at the top, and I'm gonna show you everything on this deck. This is the suite lounge. Only suite guests can come in here. All right, we're going to the loft suites. This is the Crown Loft Suite, number 54, on deck 17. So it's a two-story loft. Living room down. I'm so sorry you can't see anything. And then it's just a small balcony. I mean, this is a larger balcony than a normal balcony, but it's not a huge balcony. Gorgeous, though. Okay, so this is the upstairs. Little changing area. A bathroom with kind of a double shower. Got the pull-down TV, Okay, so this is the Royal Loft Suite, 1740. There's a nice big living room, one bedroom here that has a king. And that goes out to a balcony that has your own hot tub and wraps to the rest of the balcony here. And it turns around this corner, excuse me. And on this corner, you have like a little bar and eating area, and it overlooks the sports area, which I haven't been to yet. So there's mini golf. It looks like this is tennis and pickleball maybe, and the surfing and the rock wall and the zip line all over here. Okay, then you have a dining room that seats 8, a living room, and then upstairs a player piano. The bottom floor, this is the bathroom. It has just a single shower head. And from upstairs, you have this king that overlooks the living room. There's not a lot of privacy for this king. If you have other people in the room, you have this curtain here that you can close. That's it. And the changing area. So suite guests do get their own robes. It's interesting, I have a different robe. When I ask for a robe downstairs, it's not this one. This doesn't have a liner inside. Mine is terry. Master bath upstairs has 2 sinks and this awesome, amazing jacuzzi tub, a double head shower, a bidet, and a toilet.
Behind you, yep. The one upstairs, and then the sofa turns into the third one.
Okay, so we sleep 6 in this room, only 6. So this is the Skyloft Suite number 20. This is another loft with one bed up. Sleeps 4 people. So you've got the one bed up, and this probably turns into a bed here. Then you have the same view of the sports area. This one's the mini golf side.
Right.
And this is the bathroom. You have a two-headed shower up here, toilet, and one little sink. Who is down there, awesome Jeannie Robertson. Closet is here, like right in front of the stairs. I would like fall down the stairs personally. All right, Royal Suite number 1.
So this is our owner's panoramic one bedroom suite.
How many does it sleep?
It's 4 guests. Four. It's all one floor living. So you got a master bedroom, a master bathroom. The sofa turns into a bed. You got a smaller bathroom over this way with a walk-in closet.
So this is a little bigger bathroom, but it's a small bathroom, she said. So you were saying it gets the amenities.
So it gets a star class amenities.
Star class.
Royal Genie and the star class amenities. Yes.
Very nice. So this is a lovely suite. I like this one so far. Nice hot tub and 2 lounges. This one, they're calling this panoramic, I believe. Okay. This is all one level. You don't have stairs in this one, which some people prefer to be all on one level. This is a gorgeous big room, king bed. And this is what they mean by panoramic. Am I in your video? This is what they mean by panoramic. This huge view right in front of your bed, which is very nice. And then you've got these little lounges too. Are those separate, or is that one room? So, I like that view.
And this is the toilet and bidet. I love the panoramic suites, and then you have like a little changing room in here.
I like this. This one I like. All right, now we are at the pool areas. So I went down one, I went to 16. Now I'm gonna go down to 15 because I wanna go all the way forward and up to 17 that side. I'm gonna head up over there, I guess. All right. So we're back at 16, and then we're gonna go back up to 17 here. This is the private area for suite guests. Any grand suite and above has access to this. So they have these little cabanas that overlook the solarium area. Right, so that was deck 17, forward and aft. Now 16 is the pool deck. Uh-oh, am I stuck here? Let's see if I can get out. I can, yay. All right, so that's 17. Awesome lifeguards, can't live without them. Okay, another bar, the sandbar. So I had gotten all this yesterday, all the pool areas. It's another shopping area. Oh, there's a video arcade here. Okay. It's nice and cool in here. So this isn't like the virtual reality area in Norwegian Prima, but it's a fun little arcade area. These are the sport court options. Just in case you want to know where anything is. This is the living room. Mini golf. All right, this is the end of the zip line. Nice. The process here, once you land.
Short pants. So a full shirt that covers your shoulders, shorts, or a pair of long pants. Some socks. Otherwise, if you don't have socks, you can bring tennis shoes with laces.
Okay. All right, low rider. He's actually standing. Kinds of shoes. Every shoe possible. What, why don't you have socks then? Can I just borrow socks?
We don't have socks. So you take your own socks.
Somebody's got to have socks on board. Somewhere.
You don't bring your socks with you.
Who brings socks on a cruise?
In Caribbean, yeah.
Oh, well, you
have your shoes with laces.
Sandals. No, I have loafers.
So I need socks and shoes.
And shorts, and I have to cover my shoulders?
Yes, and your belly also, so it's no down top. So nice wrapping t shirts with you cover your shoulders.
Why is that important on a zip line?
Because we will put harness on you, and it's going to help you sleep.
Oh, so I see.
The harness will hold your weight. So if it's all open, it's going to wrap your skin.
So are short shorts okay? Like really booty shorts?
Yeah, like this bed shorts. Is okay.
Yeah. Okay, and then, but I have to find socks somehow. Yeah. I will go on a scavenger hunt and find socks. I'm going to find socks. When are you closed today?
Till 6.
Oh, home. All right, so this is the Wipeout Bar back here. I am so bummed. I need to find some socks. Who wears socks on Royal Caribbean? Oh, this is a different flow rider over here. Two flow riders. I think my model of the last one was way better. So it looks like this is the pickleball court where I'm gonna try to play with Vicky in a little bit. This is the Wipeout Cafe. So they have some snacks in here. Tacos, quesadillas. Hi. I just wanted to say hello. Laura is going to let me have her socks. I love Laura. She's going to give me socks. I love her.
Are you ready?
Yes. Oh, yay. Try to do this. I'm not good at it at all. Hey, woohoo! Boogie board!
So what I need you to do, man, before I let you sign the waiver?
Yes.
You need to watch the video for 2 minutes. Please pay attention. All the safety information is in this video. So after the video, there's a quiz.
I do really well on tests.
Okay. Okay, so for the whole cruise.
Oh, nice.
Please do not remove it.
Okay.
If happens that you need to remove it and still you need to want to ride the flow rider, then you need to come here again on the desk, watch the video, warm up movement, sign the waiver again.
Okay. All right. So I had to sign this waiver.
Yes.
And I also had to do, I had to do a test of my movements, which are those right there.
You have to be able to move like that.
the pickleball tournament with Vicky Free. Vicky is actually playing every single person who signed up for the tournament. It's crazy.
That is truly unthinkable. I learned the rules about 20 minutes ago. Here we go. 57.002. Right, that's good. Hey, come on, Amy Lang. 102. Jessica and Jesse, they haven't lost a game yet. Oh, it's
yeah.
Good.
Oh.
Oh, it's a great mission.
All right.
When you get $1,000 in marketing money, co-op marketing. Oh, it's in. Even better return. That's good. Double landing back down.
Oh, nice.
Jesse on the back of the net. Oh, yeah. Like a salmon.
Woo.
Oh, look at this.
Oh.
Match point. It's good, Vicky. Coming. Oh, Jess is in.
She's so funny.
How does it go? 4-0-2. Vicky serving it. Jesse returns. Ken. Vicky. Whoa! Our best competitors yet. Have a photo with Jesse and Vicky on that side of the court, guys.
And I even got a zip liner.
They're very good, these two.
Ready for formal night, and I got my new bag. It's perfect. Holds my charger, my charging block, my glasses, my phone. Well, maybe not my tripod. Tonight we're in silk, and they ran out of tables that were smaller, so we're gonna share with people we don't know, which will be interesting, but that's the way classic cruising used to be, so that's all right. On formal night, you usually get a better menu, so. Ooh, I love beef carpaccio. Yummy. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, for the tonight, my recommendation, I have the beef carpaccio. It's the raw of beef. We serve with the arugula on the top and some the Parmesan cheese. And the dressing is the Dijon mustard dressing. Okay, and for your meals, we have the roasted beef tenderloin. We serve with some the mashed potato, and for your dessert we have the carrot cake.
So I'm gonna get this lobster today. I know it costs extra, but I want lobster. And usually they put it on lobster on formal night.
Yes, I mean
on the menu on formal night. It's my beautiful carpaccio. I love it. Oh, I just want to
know.
We have this on the Odyssey of the Seas, and it looks very similar. So I'm sure it's very similar, but it was delicious. It's very hard. It's very so thin that you can't get a good forkful of it, though. It kind of falls apart. But I love carpaccio. It melts in your mouth. It's so good. I love carpaccio, though. But they do it very well. So this is the tenderloin that comes with the complimentary menu tonight. All right, now there's my lobster beautiful that is $30 extra. Well worth it. Yes, I would love butter.
You want me to put on the...
Yes.
Just make it swim the lobster, okay?
Make it perfect. Love it. Thank you so much.
Welcome, enjoy.
Oh my God, that's not there.
She's got all the lobster.
Yeah, she knows what she's doing. So when I see a whole lobster on the menu, I expect claws. I expect an entire lobster. This, they gave me the middle. It's delicious, but there's no claw. I just want to make sure you understand when you get the whole lobster, it is not really a whole lobster. But maybe, I mean, I guess you could say that's the claw.
It looks beautiful. I love lobster since I was like 8 years old, much to my parents' distress. This is good, good lobster. And they crack it for you. I hate getting messy. Good. Here's my beautiful Grand Marnier souffle. You know I have to. But, whoops! Oh, it's kind of hard. It's not very soft in the middle. Yummy. Carrot cake. And what is that one?
That's the peach.
Oh, the peach shortcake. Lovely.
No. Miranda's
ow.
Used to it.
Ow.
It's very hot.
You're used to it already? Wow, that was fast. So, Lainey, if it's not.
Well, hang on a second. I have to do my first bite.
The name you told Monica was very impressive.
I don't know. It's kind of doughy. It's not very souffle-y. It's got a really interesting taste. It's not terrible, but it's not like a souffle. But thank you, Royal. A delicious dinner for four women.
All right, casino. This is Studio B, where the ice skating is. This is my beautiful chocolate espresso martini. They went and ran and got some espresso for me. Thank you. We're in on air where they're gonna do karaoke. It's like a sports bar.
Have an answer, or would you like to use one of your lifetimes? It's not a tricky question. Use a microphone. You got honey, bumblebee, queen, or booby? Who do you come quiz with? You are as the audience. Okay, you're gonna put one of your lifetimes. All right, she would like to ask you, audience. All right, audience, please make some noise for the answer that you believe is the correct answer. Audience, is it A, Pommy?
No.
Is it B, Bumble?
No.
Is it C, Queen?
No.
Is it D, Booby?
Yeah.
So now that you have a little bit of help, what would you like? D, that is your final answer? Are you sure?
I'm
100%. All right, 100%. Ladies and gentlemen, on 3, 2, 1, it is Boo, ladies and gentlemen! Lindsay, you just get yourself a highlighter in your bag. Lindsay.
So this is the bar that goes up and down, and it looks like it's going up. It goes up super slow.
Motown.
Thank you.
Thank you.
is here somehow. This is crazy.
Ow! Ow! I don't want to do it! Wherever you're facing the rising tide area, you guys follow along with us. It's pretty easy. We're going to start off by going to the right. Here we go. To the left. Take it back. And forward. And kick. Kick. Jump, drop, roll, tuck. Roll those hands, trick it. Front, back, side, and turn. And kick. Kick. Jump, drop, roll, tuck. Roll your hands, chicken. Front, back, side, and turn. Kick, kick. Jump, drop, roll, tuck. Roll those hands, chicken. Front, back, side, turn. Everybody, it's time to shake that booty!
I can do that.
Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your booty. Shake your booty. Let's go. Let's turn around now. You can have what's up anymore. I'm just trying. All what is wrong is I know how to do it. I know I'm still alive. I got all my life to do. I got all my love to do. I'll survive. I will survive. Hey, hey. Woo!
Disco party is at the pizza place, Sorrento's. So they have some stuff here like mixed seafood, like polenta, and mussels. So they don't just have pizza. This is my midnight feast. Okay, I can't believe how much I'm eating on this cruise. And I'm going to the Norwegian Encore next. Not a good way to start. I love mozzarella and tomato salad. And they have like an octopus or crab salad, seafood salad. That's just so good. These mussels that are like smothered in tomato sauce. This is a really big mussel. I couldn't find a napkin. So I'm a little worried about eating this. It's very tomato-y. And this is the veggie pizza in the bar. I really liked this last night. Super hot. It's always good to get the fresh pizza as they take them out of the oven. It's really big crust. I'm not going to eat a lot. I just needed a little something before bed. And then tomorrow I'm diving with dolphins in Cosmos. So exciting. So I need to get some sleep tonight. I probably shouldn't have drunk anything. But it's not like a real dive though. It's just like a mini dive. So, you have to stay on ship time. There's an hour difference in Cozumel. So just make sure you know what time it is on the ship and don't miss the ship.
Yum. So this is Valero's.
So there's something in my lock. What is it? Oh, what time is it? To remind you about the time change tomorrow in Cozumel. Aw, I love it when they give me little animals. An elephant. Thank you, Royal. All right, we're in Cozumel today. It's Friday. It means we're in Cozumel. All right, gangway is on three. All right, gangway. Good morning. Thank you. Maybe. Yeah. Hi, you're giving out water bottles or...
Want a bottle?
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah,
well,
have a water, please.
Water as well.
And towels too, huh? You have to check it out? 11601.
How many do you want?
Just one. So when I come back in, I just give it to you here?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye, guys. Oh, and is this for when you come back? No. Thank you. All right. Allure of the Seas. Welcome to Cozumel. And we're going to be all aboard at 1:30 ship time. There's an hour difference. Don't bring any food back. Good morning. Hi. Oh, is that, is that a map?
Yes, it's shopping map.
All right. Oh, we're right next to Celebrity, my friends. Good morning from Cozumel. It is a beautiful day today. I'm gonna go diving with dolphins at Tonkinob Park. So I've done this before and I loved it and I really missed my dolphin friend. I do care so much about marine animals and all animals. I used to protest animal abuse. And I know that some people are really offended by activities like this, but I don't know how to, I'm not gonna give an excuse for it. I just love it. I love them and I love touching them and being with them. And I love diving in the ocean with them, free, as you know, more than anything. But it's hard to do that with dolphins. They're very fast. Wait, it's the Celebrity Beyond. I just got off this ship. How did that get here? God, Celebrity's following me. And Carnival Glory is here, and oh my gosh, my new A-friends on Holland America are here too. Welcome to Cozumel. We are here with like every great big ship that I have been on in the last few months. So it should be a great day. Follow along. You can see the size difference between the Celebrity Beyond on the right and the Allure of the Seas on the left. It's pretty amazing, the difference. When you're on the Beyond, it feels like you're on a pretty big ship, but and the way that the Allure is set up, laid out, with the neighborhoods, it really doesn't feel that big. I love it. I love it way more than I loved the Odyssey this last summer. One of the activities that you can do is like a snorkel trip, a catamaran, and you can just walk right over there. I always just go to Margaritaville, have a drink, or a tequila, a go-go. You can see El Cid is right behind Tequila a Go-Go. Yeah, it looks like they have a dog to sniff for something. Okay, there's a handy map here to see. I don't have far to go to get to Tonkinob.
So if you have shore excursions with Royal Caribbean, you meet up right over here and you look for your sign. I'm just looking for a taxi. I just need to go to the taxi stand. Oh, this is the Fury catamaran, people. So it's behind the yellow building. All right, you just follow the signs to the taxi. Chunkin' Hub is all over. I already have my ticket. I'm on my way.
Cuba.
Cuba. I'm good. No, I don't shop. Thank you. Maybe, but I doubt it. Taxi this way. And more taxi signs this way. Oh, that way. They're trying to confuse me. They want you to pass by every single shopping booth. Yeah, vanilla, but you're not allowed to bring food on board. All right, following the crowd to the taxis. Everybody's out here for anything you would possibly want. Of course, let me book you before you leave. Here's the taxi line.
Taxi over
here? Taxi, Chunkin' Hub. $12 to Chunkin' Hub, one
Chunkin' Hub Park.
Okay.
National State Park.
And if I have two people?
It's same price, it's 1 to 4.
Okay. Ah, 1 to 4. Okay, awesome. So you have like fixed pricing here.
Exactly.
Okay.
$12 one way, 1 to 4.
Got it. Thank you.
Welcome to Costa Mesa.
Thank you. Not very long line. This is way hot. Hey, this is my great big cab all for me. I'm sorry, it's just me. So right outside the terminal, there is a street where you can walk up and down for shopping. Chunkin' Hub already, that was super fast. Thank you. Oh, I already have a ticket. Come right back here when I need to get a taxi back, and there are always people to pick up. Thank you so much for your help today. I already bought my ticket online direct, and they want me to check in out here first. I do. I got it online. Inside to the check-in.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. So just in case you missed all the shopping at the port, you can shop out here too. Also have ice cream and sodas here, but you get lunch, a lunch buffet inside. Hi, I have my wrist. Okay. Thank you. See? I have access. So this is Chunkin' Hub National Park. They have snorkeling here, animal encounters, all sorts of things to do here. And they have a lunch buffet included. I have to check in at the dolphin area right here. Dolphin Discovery. Close we are to the port, ships are right there. Chunkin' Hub is pretty large and there are a lot of areas to explore here. You can be with manatees, dolphins. I kind of wanted to do the manatees, but I forgot and I did the dolphins first. So this is the check-in, I think. Yeah, check-in area. Maybe I can find a good Rashi here. Yes, I'm diving with the dolphins. Yep.
Well, we're not going in the park.
We just want to check in. Okay. It's for the diving activity. I will give you one more bracelet. Okay. The first bracelet is the access to the park.
Okay.
You can enjoy the park, the botanical garden, archaeological site, the lagoon, beach area. Okay.
I have two already.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. It's the access. The third one is for the dolphin activity.
Oh. Okay.
Okay, so I get a taxi back included with my activity. I had no idea. Awesome.
So just to let you know, when you book a dolphin activity here, you can't bring a camera inside. You can observe for $5 from the outside without a camera, but you buy their photo package. So their photo package for one photo is $40, for 12 is $70, and no videos, just photos. And the new law may affect how they do any of this. So we'll see what happens when that passes.
Just if you come back like in maybe 30 minutes.
Hopefully I'll see my real
get some snacks, coffee, soft drinks. There's also a restaurant over here. That's the manatee area. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see the manatee. But you can see their reaction. So they do snooba here and sea trek as well if you don't dive. Hola.
Nice call, company.
Oh, no, thank you. This is the little walk-in beach area.
Hi, beautifuls.
Hi.
Hi. Hi!
Look at this guy. This is the bigger beach. I tried to snorkel off of this before and it's really rough. Yeah, how rough this is to try to snorkel right here. So they have a little trouble with my ship time. They wanted to have me here from 12 to 3 o'clock and not let me go in the water until 2:30. Our ship leaves at 1:30. Ship time is an hour different, but even with that, I wouldn't have enough time. So they're trying to rearrange me so I can get in earlier. I'm gonna go check to see if they got it done. Okay, I found my waiting spot. It's like they have massage down there. So if I can't get in with the dolphins, I'm gonna find something to do. Tequila museum over there. They got me in. I get to go to the dive shop at 11:30, which is right now. Yay!
Straight ahead, all this way down. Passing the beach area, almost at the end, there's where you're gonna meet the Zapato Diver House, okay?
Okay.
So
I'll... Okay, yay. I'm so happy they got me in earlier so I can go. So I have to go check in with the dive master right now. And then my dive with the dolphins is in an hour. So they have to check me out first, make sure that I know how to dive, which I do. So, such a relief. I'm so excited.
Number six, the guy's been here since, I don't know what.
Okay, I'm at Zapata. Those are my guys. Hello, I'm Lainey Melnick. Oh,
hola,
cutie.
You know diving?
Yes.
If you must steam up, break the seal, shake your head, then blow.
Okay.
Let me choose a nice.
Okay, we have to walk and do a beach dive. And then we're going to swim and dive over to the pens and have to get out and then wait for our turn. Should be in good shape to do this. So it's a little rough here to get in. We're gonna put on our fins and swim. Like Cinderella, he's gonna take care of me. Oh, this one.
See, yeah, sleepy grass.
Thank you. I love service.
Thank you.
And you can hold the thing on the water outside.
Hi, baby. Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Louise. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For coming, my name is Juan Luis too.
So I'm a mess, but it was Eduardo was a fabulous dive master. We saw a huge barracuda.
Yeah, it was a big barracuda.
We saw cute little stingrays. Yes,
a very baby stingray. And maybe 2 day born.
The other one that spotted, what's it called again? The spotted fish we saw that.
Oh, it's a spotted drum fish. Spotted drum fish, and also trunk fish, you know, the bigger one. It was a baby one, and then there was a bigger one.
We had a great time. And of course, the dolphins.
The dolphins.
Luis,
yeah,
Luis, my dolphin. Yeah. He was beautiful.
He's amazing, yeah. He likes to.
That was a great day, and I have time to go home, or back to the ship. I actually think I need to go back to the ship right now. That was awesome, but now I have to rush back to the ship because we are leaving soon, and so I can't even take advantage of this awesome day pass. But it's fun. If you have more time, you can have lunch, relax, go to the beach, snorkel, have fun. But oh my God, my time with the dolphins was so special. Luis loved me. I loved him. He was very sweet, very soft. I loved, it was really different this time than the last time I was here. I think I had more time like really touching him, but before they let me kind of ride around on like holding on to his fin. and this time they don't do that anymore, which is probably better for the dolphins. It's safer. So whatever is better for them is okay with me. I don't think you can get the whole thing in. I don't know how to make the U. You're supposed to make a U, but I don't understand that. Eduardo said I was like a mermaid in the water, which was very nice. I really appreciate that because usually people who dive with me complain about how I'm all over the place and what a mess I am. So he was very sweet. Alright, now I just need a taxi. Very easy. There is a taxi waiting for me. So now a really quick drive back to the ship. Alright, and we're back at the port. So you can shop for just about anything here while you're in port. Ship. No, thank you. Alright, the new A is in port. Allure, Celebrity Beyond. Oh. So you actually have to stand in line then to get through security. Celebrity Beyond and Allure in one shot. The new A with the Carnival Glory. We have one more sea day and then back, and then Norwegian Encore for a week, November 13 to 21. So be sure to follow along. I am gonna finish all of my in-depth videos, I promise you. So I just want to show you the difference. Royal Caribbean is letting people in here, and I'm going to show you what Celebrity's got going on. Since we didn't have a port with Celebrity Beyond, you never saw what they did when you came back from an excursion. Give you a cold towel. Don't give it to me. I'm on that ship. And they give you, thank you. They give you water, and it's lemon and cucumber. And then back on the beautiful Beyond.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Right after you check in, then you go and you give the towel back. Hi, thank you. Actually, 1:25 ship time, which means I made it 5 minutes to go. I never cut it this close. Don't do that. Give yourself at least 30 minutes. Don't do what I do. Trying the hot dogs at the boardwalk, my favorite place in the world. The everything vine with, I think I'll just go classic hot dog with sauerkraut and onions and cheese. Please, do you have cheese? Cheese, all right. So these are the different hot dog options. You can do a brat, chicken and apple sausage, and a Sicilian pork sausage. All right, there it is. This is the dog house. You can put stuff on here. All right. So you know I'm a Chicago girl, so hot dogs are my thing. And this is not a Chicago dog in the least, but it's a Coney dog. So we are on the boardwalk, like New York. But this is new for me. I've never had the everything bun here, so I'm really curious.
Ready?
It's tasty. I mean, I'm starving right now because after my dives, I get really hungry. And it tastes really good to me right now because I'm really hungry. So it's not a Chicago dog, but it is good, and I like the everything bun on it. Delicious. There's Corey Wallace. Oh my God. I could have been on there still, but I left. Maybe I'll see one of my friends. We're sailing away. Goodbye, Beyond. People in their robes at the front. We saw Corey. I have a good video of him. He was in the bar that was right there last time I saw him. They're all like, she was just here. I got way better pictures of the Beyond from here than I did the whole time I was there.
Rainbow.
The best bartenders on board, come on!
My name is Lazar.
You wish.
So Lazar, what are you making me?
Daily's banana cola.
Ah, nice!
And it's not professional. Otherwise, I'm more for the fun. People are professional, okay?
I trust you. You look very trustworthy. He wants to get in your video. This is the BBC. Oh my God, I love this food. Banana liqueur, pina colada. Delicious. My favorite drink in the world.
So we're making a video.
Yes. And you're the star.
She's making vlog.
People love to watch people make drinks.
I like to watch drinks coming when I'm on the beach. Because, girl, you're killing me. I don't know what to make. Now, because you were so nice with me, I'll make something special for you.
Oh, don't put bananas in.
Girl, I brought your drink. Stop. Martini glass. We put the martini glass. We put the chocolate. I call this a vortex of life. I'm joking, I don't call it like that.
Okay.
So, first, we need to go like this. You're asking yourself why. Ask yourself.
Me too.
Ask yourself, why am I doing this? Because I'm an artist.
He's an artist. Oh, let's
see. Don't interrupt me now.
He didn't do this for me.
The most important question.
Oh, I bet it's going to be a hard.
What is it gonna be?
Well, if this chocolate is not melting like this.
Is it a ship?
I know, right? It's a Superman.
Or is it a frog? It's a ship. You are such an artist.
What? No, it's BB W.
Wait, turn it the wrong way. Beautiful. Where are you from? Oh, Montenegro. I love booking Montenegro. Why? Just because we keep wanting more? Yeah, there's Bailey's.
What is
it? Wasn't there
Bailey's? What is he making?
A mudslide.
A what?
A mudslide. This one.
Tell me honest.
This one is a BBC.
It's Picasso, even
Bailey's
close.
Banana liqueur.
I know, right?
Yes, I did. Yeah.
Of course, I made it. You didn't. He didn't want to cancel. No! Thank you.
Thank you. I don't know him. No. I know that he makes good drinks though. He came to see our favorite bartender.
Ew, look at that martini. So we're in the champagne and martini bar. Julia's fabulous.
That's really interesting.
Unique, you see?
Julie, where are you from?
I'm from Brazil.
Oh, of course.
You're Rio.
All right, my favorite things. Wait, am I getting two? Oh, what happened? This is Jason. Jason, where are you from?
Philippines, Manila.
Ah, there's a lot of people from the Philippines here.
Well, it's not that I'm picky. Yeah, this is your job, so you're back in office. Actually, you're in the right spot. So that's where you need it.
Tonight we're trying American Icon Grill on deck 3. So good. Today's menu. Look what they just brought us, a cheese and fruit sandwich. And
salmon tartare.
Thank you. So I got steak Diane without the potato. Okay, they cooked it perfectly for me. This is the steak Diane. I asked for no potatoes, so they gave me double veggies. You can order whatever you want on board. You can have as many starters as you want, as many mains. So it's perfect looking, delicious. That's a very good entree. The steak diet. Tastes delicious.
Oh, beautiful tiramisu. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Somebody helped me this morning. They're like, you're not quite in the frame. Can I do it for you?
You're in the frame. So is Janet.
Oh.
And Sherry's elbow.
All right, tiramisu. Hard to please me because I've had the very best in the world. We'll see. It's tasty. It's good. Nothing totally has blown me away though. This is so much.
Coffee, madame.
Oh, thank you.
Coffee for you as well.
Nothing.
Any coffee?
Royal Caribbean, Norwegian, Carnival. You don't expect fabulous food in the main dining. If you want fabulous, amazing food, specialty dining. That's kind of the whole reason why they have the specialty dining restaurants. To give you variety, to do something different and interesting. I wish I could have shown you some on this ship, but they follow me on Norwegian Encore, and I have a dining package. I will have a different specialty dining restaurant every night.
accept this one?
Hello.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. I love fresh flowers in a cruise ship. That's so awesome. Have to walk through the casino. Tonight is comedy live. So exciting. You have to get here early or you won't get a seat. I have this nice little bar here for the comedy show. Hi.
What can I get?
Anything.
Well, do you have like Bailey's or something like that? Like a, how about a Black Russian or White Russian?
This is the Comedy Live venue, and as you can see, there's not a lot of seats in here, so that's why you have to come early, get in line to get your seat.
Miami Vice.
And how y'all doing tonight? Welcome everybody, welcome to Comedy Live, and welcome to our adult comedy show. Now, it's an adult comedy show, so we may have some explicit content. So, so if you do feel like you may be easily offended, this might not be the best place for you. Here is your first comedian. You've seen him on Spy TV. You've seen him on MTV. You've seen him with Oprah. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let me hear you for Don Gray!
You're a cute little suit. I love you, man. You're like the Funko Pop version of James Bond. I love that shit. Like if James Bond was cuddling and had too many cookies, I love you, man. Oh, shut up. Like you haven't had too many cookies, too. How you doing, Santa? How are you?
Commercials, and he has over 18 years in comedy, and he is one of Royal Caribbean's favorites. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Tyrone Hawkins!
Keep going for Adam, y'all, and Don Gray.
Man, y'all feel good? Yeah.
I got my beautiful turn down service. No chocolates on my pillows here, by the way. And a little survey, I think. And I sat in my strawberry daiquiri for the entire comedy show, so I have to change. Good thing there is laundry service on cruise ships. Wow, the casino's hopping tonight. So unusual here. Get all these people.
To do it ourselves. So one more time for all the veterans out there. Out there. One more time.
And we got so one up here.
And we have our very own tour.
Yeah, look right here too.
He's right here. Yes, sir. Start a little conversation. Just take five.
Pulling my trigger, now he's dead. Magnificat. I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy, but the poor family's dead in his life, but this monstrosity.
Thank you.
the Bow and Stern Pub. I actually haven't been here yet. Oh, man. That's a lot of Baileys. Is that all Baileys?
No. Baileys with something inside.
Oh, okay. Oh my God. It's so good. Baileys and butterscotch. So good. San Jose.
What's up?
It was so awesome tonight. Amazing. You have to find it in Las Vegas.
The homes in the bar, in the bar, down in the valley, oh, oh, oh.
So this is cabin 162 on deck 11, which is a category 1A balcony.
And then there's an alcove right here. I don't know if you passed
it. Oh, I see. Yeah. That's the little ultra.
Yeah, so they've got these.
So this is like an ocean view balcony.
Yeah, what I like about that,
with a, I believe it's a spacious balcony.
Oh, do they?
There's a closet. And then we have two full closets out here.
There you go.
Yeah.
This is a spacious balcony, right?
Yeah, ultra spacious.
Ultra.
Oh,
I didn't see this bunk beds.
You got it.
Oh.
Yeah, the only.
So this sleeps four, and they have like a bunk bed.
One bath.
Very cool. And it's one bathroom. You are.
So
this is 134. It is an ultra spacious ocean view, also with those bunk beds.
Oh, yeah, we saw that.
And this has a big, large porthole. So you can see the ocean. But there's no balcony. So this is cabin 104, which is a standard ocean view. So this one has an interesting window, but it's standard. Right, so we're on deck 14, cabin 170. This is an ocean view balcony. And you can see how they have the third in a pull down bed. And this is the balcony, deck 14, cabin 244, which is an owner suite that sleeps four people.
This does connect to a balcony as well, so you have the option to purchase the balcony next door as well.
One king bed. A nice large oversized balcony for the owner suite. It's our last full day on the ship, so I am running around seeing as many cabins as I possibly can to show you everything.
So after we finish,
so we're in deck 14, cabin 330, which is a spacious aqua.
Spacious aqua theater suite.
Aqua theater suite.
More ocean view than aqua theater, but you still get the aqua theater.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So the aqua theater, you can't really see from here at all. It's kind of. So this is a one king. So you can't see that aqua theater. I would not recommend this if you're gonna spend money on an aqua theater suite and not see the aqua theater. So this is deck 10, cabin 254. This is a two-bedroom grand suite.
This one's a one-bedroom.
Oh, one-bedroom, sorry.
One-bedroom,
One-bedroom.
Page 39.
No, you're fine, right here. Thank you.
This looks like it's inaccessible.
This one is not.
It's not? There's not an accessible.
It's just a big bathroom.
Okay, and there's a nice big desk, a king bed.
Is this the sofa?
This is queen sofa bed. And an oversized balcony. Say it's a one bedroom, but it's just a curtain that goes across. Deck 10, cabin 244. This is the two bedroom grand suite, and I guess it has a doorbell.
It has a doorbell.
I tested it for you.
So this is a queen sofa.
All the suites have
double.
a demo.
I need it over here because I don't have very much ink.
And then there's an oversized balcony. You said it's 2 bed and 2 bath?
Yep.
Okay. Oops, sorry, sorry.
Mr. Stumper.
There's the second bathroom, small. There is a door on this bedroom. There is a second bedroom with a door, and you can sleep 4 people in here. The beds come down from the top, and you can put 2 on the couch, so it sleeps 8. This is deck 10, cabin 330. Opens with a bathroom. Hi. 1 king bed in here, separate completely from the rest, with its own bathroom. Then there's another bedroom right here. This has the 2 beds that come down again, so this room would sleep 4 if you'd like. And then there's a living room. Hi. I don't know where I am. And Jeannie's here. What is this category?
So this is the Aqua Theater Suite 2 bedroom. It's part of the Star Class. So it does come with a Royal Jeannie.
Okay, so this is the 2 bedroom Aqua Theater Suite. With a large balcony. And I'll show you the Aqua Theater from here. Aqua Theater suites overlook the Aqua Theater, but you have to like stand at the edge to actually watch anything. I am right here on the edge. They do have like a little bar here, so you can sit and have a bar in front of you while you watch. But I don't know if this is like the best view in the house, although you can see the top deck divers pretty well. Can see the rock wall. You look over at the Central Park, or I'm sorry, the boardwalk balconies over to the left, and you have the ocean side to the right, and an oversized balcony. It's cabin 149. Corey, you interrupted me. So this is an inside cabin that sleeps 2. This is deck 8, cabin 630. This is a junior suite. You can see that they separate the bedroom with a curtain to a living room. You can use coastal kitchen when you're in a junior suite.
This is a J3. Will accommodate more than 2 people. So this room will accommodate 5. You have 2 on the bed, 2 on the pullout, and then that is a bunk bed that comes down with a guardrail and a step ladder.
Right, so this is deck 8, cabin 730. It's another 2-bedroom Aqua Theater suite. Walk in, and there's a bathroom. And then there's a bedroom this way for a king. And you get like a little sitting area and your own little balcony with your own bath. That's 1 bedroom. And then across the hall is the 2nd bedroom that can be sleeping 4 again. You can separate to 2 bunks and 2 twins. And then this is the full living room. And let's see what the view is like out here on this one. This is deck 8. So again, you have to, you know, sit at the bar to be able to watch the show. You're kind of across from the top dive platform, so you won't see the bottom very well. But it is hard to get seats for the Aqua shows. Say hi! Okay, let me go in this way. And there is a dining area as well in here. Whoops. 6, you're gonna find shore excursions, the photo gallery. And this is for you to find all the professional photos that were made of you when you have been sailing. Little
professional photographers go around and offer you photos all the time. You do have to pay for them. Across the way is Schooner Bar. Oh, I have a dead end.
Yeah.
Getting ready for a parade, but I have two more stamps to get. Six dead ends after Schooner Bar and the shore excursions and photo area. So you have to go one down and over to get to... So this is the Solarium, which has a lovely, more quiet lunch than going in the big buffet. Hi. They do have some hot stuff here too. Barbecue chicken. They're carving prime. They have some grill here that looks delicious. And of course some salads. So you can sit in here, it's air conditioned, or you can go out into the Solarium area that's not air conditioned. Oh, you need some drinks, yay. I'm gonna make myself an iced coffee because I need a coffee in the morning. But you can make whatever you want, that's free. I would love it. Are you gonna give me one? Oh, you're not gonna give me one?
No, no, this one is quite fat, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Try this, obviously.
Sure, thank you. Oh my God. That is so good. That Munster cheese, oh my God.
That's okay?
That's way too much. Whoa. Wow, look at that cheese. Yum, thank you so much. And the desserts. So I don't eat a whole lot of lunch, but I love really good like antipasto and tomato and mozzarella salad. This is in pesto, and it's really tasty. I love it. So this is a great option for like a light lunch, or you can make it as heavy as you want. You could get a whole bunch of potatoes and meats and whatever you want. Lots of desserts. Soups today, you have sweet potato and Texas clam chowder,
yeah.
Which is the best.
Oh, sage Texas.
Okay.
Texas is the best.
All right, can I have some, please?
Texas clam chowder.
All right,
you. Can
thank
take the
you.
Spoon just behind you.
Okay, thank you. Gotta start our last sea day right. Yum. Me some more goodies in my room. Oh, that's my bill. And then disembarkation information. I'm just going to carry off my luggage, so I don't need to worry about this. But they assign you times to leave, and you can put your luggage out. Thank you. Serving us some goodies here.
In the Northeast, and we are thrilled to be back in Australia, New Zealand, and Asia.
And this is only a fraction, just so you know.
And we have a total of 60 strategic account managers, 26 business development specialists. In addition, we have national account managers. You know we have the best training team in the industry. And they're already leaving. Okay, give them a round of applause. Thanks, you guys. But does anybody know what else sails out of Galveston? We have 5 ships. Look at these. Okay, so we all know Allure. 4, 5, and 7 night Western Caribbean from now until October of 2023. What comes in November of 2023?
Harmony.
Absolutely, Harmony. We are so excited that the Harmony will be here through April of 2024. Now we also have our little one-off, the Radiance of the Seas, that will be here doing 9 and 10 night Western Caribbean, January through April. So it is right around the corner. So please take a look at those itineraries. And did I hear somebody say you want to go to Perfect Day out of Galveston?
Yeah!
Especially for your Crown and Anchor members, they love this ship. And you can go on a 9-night Perfect Day Western Caribbean out of Galveston. There are not that many of those sailings, so make sure if you want to go to Perfect Day, you grab that quickly. Now, just in port yesterday was the beautiful Adventure of the Seas, 4 and 5 night Western Caribbean, from now until April of 2023. And then comes the beautiful Voyager of the Seas. Does anybody remember 1999? She is a totally different ship than the one that you saw here in 1999. Completely refurbished, specialty dining, extra activities, and she'll be coming from May 2023 through April of 2024. I can't guarantee that we'll have those inflatable horns on the front of the ship like we had in 1999. We actually sold those in a charity auction, and a rancher, I think out of San Antonio, bought those. So I can only imagine what his cows think with those inflatable things. Summer in Europe, and the Wonder of the Seas is no exception. She spent all her summer in Europe, and she is back now, sailing out of Port Canaveral. Just opening deployment now. Alaska and Hawaii, as I mentioned, opens this week. Europe opens next week. And then what we've been waiting for, year-round deployment and summer Caribbean will open on December 12th. So.
I was getting booked if you need guest services. Come down here at the end of the promenade. Seven Hearts, which is on Deck 14, and it's like the game area with computers.
It is super, super windy and cold as we're getting back towards Galveston. People are wearing long sleeves, long pants. So if you cruise out of Galveston or other northern ports, just be aware it can get cold as you get back towards your home port. Be ready. Super windy today to finish the tournament. But Vicky is an amazing woman.
Here is in. Beautiful. A6-1. Give them a round of applause.
Nobody can beat this woman. She's been playing nonstop for 2 days. Vicky the winner.
It's good on the line.
Nice.
She's gone.
Oh, nice.
Yes, it's good. I'm teasing. 2-1. This is the biggest moment of your life. Come on. Yes, it is. Yes, Ricky. Haven't lost one game today. 8. No! 11-8-2. Gamway and Kent almost ruined their record. Ricky and Jesse have today won 17 matches in a row.
17 so Ricky and Jesse matches in a row. Woohoo! The queen, she's the champion. I did not, because she cannot be beat.
There you go.
So there have been 2 days of tournaments for pickleball, and Vicky has won 15 out of 16 matches yesterday, and 17 out of 17 matches today. She is my hero. I love Vicky Freed. She's not only the queen of cruising and travel, but she is the queen of pickleball.
Saturday, must be a sea day.
The rumor is that Cafe Promenade has Irish coffees today. They have it, woohoo! So you can get all sorts of goodies here. And Irish coffee, extra charges do apply normally. All right, so this is the special drink they made me. Thank you. It's hot coffee with Kahlua and Bailey's called the Captain's Call. I can't get to the drink. It's super hot, which is great because it's super cold outside. But it's good. I'm just not sure. It's not quite Irish coffee, or I'm not sure what it is.
I just wanted to say a heartfelt thank you for joining us for these 4 days. We've had so much fun with all of you, and we hope that you've seen our appreciation for the hard times that you guys have gone through in the last couple of years. And we're back, and we're back bigger than ever, back here in Texas, and we're the speaking of big, many of you saw Jay's wonderful presentation on the Icon of the Seas, our next newest ship. And tonight, we are going to give away 10 cruises. Thank you, everybody.
This is the Chardonnay that's complimentary. It's not my favorite wine. I actually have a lobster tail for me today. Yay.
Thank you.
And a beef tenderloin. Oh, and a molten chocolate cake and baked Alaska. Okay, so I ended up buying a glass of the Moscato because I really don't like that Chardonnay. It's $9 for one glass, $33 for the bottle. It's good, it's not great, but it's good. You can buy a fabulous wine for more money, but I don't like to spend money on wine when I get free drinks. It doesn't make much sense to me. But anyway, cheers.
Okay, I think it means it.
Okay, so this is the onion tart. It's like a quiche. It's delicious. I really like this. I love quiche, and this is very, very, what's it called? Fluffy. It's fluffy. Tastes really good. Tasty. That's my lobster tail. A little small tonight. So my lobster tail is teeny tiny. So you can always say, hey, I would like the beef tenderloin and the lobster tail. You can order whatever you want, as much as you want. It cannot say no. But it's a little small, but it's tender, tastes all right. It's not fabulous. I think the lobster I got from Chops the other night was better. But of course I paid for that. Okay, this is the chocolate molten cake. I'm gonna test it for you. Let's see.
I don't know.
Not very molty.
It fell flat, didn't it?
But it is moist in the middle. Better than nothing. It is not warm. It's kind of lukewarm, but it has a good chocolate taste to it. It's kind of like my escargot yesterday. They were lukewarm, not hot, but it's tasty still. Try the moving elevator bar, Rising Tide. All right.
You're drinking.
I know. Well, I have. I just left here.
No, it's cold.
So so we're actually moving. We're going up now. It's going very, very slowly, so your drinks don't spill. I assume that's why. But it is a little disconcerting to be going up when you're going wavy also.
Yeah.
But I like it.
Have a couple of cocktails, you're going to get off and on.
I know, well that, yeah, that's the problem.
This is the floor I came in on.
So you only move two decks? 1, 5, 6, 7, 8. You only move four decks. But it's a good thing not to get confused about what deck you're on when you get on and off. Don't drink too much.
Oh, you know, one question.
Well, I didn't know if
getting closer, we're almost there. We're almost there. I see Central Park. We moved, so we got a table.
I have to put my drink on a table or I will make a mess. Even if I have my drink on a table, I make a mess.
My Cosmo. Oh, it is super strong. We're moving. Very slowly, but we're moving. Going down. Going down seems more exciting to me.
I don't know why.
We love Julie so much. She brings us a treat. I know. Yay! Oh, she gave me a heart. I love that. Thank you, Julie. Another silent disco. Woohoo!
Hey, 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 hey
comedian Tyrone Hawkins.
Hey, we in the dark.
Follow Tyrone on what?
Tyrone Debut on Instagram.
On Instagram.
Yeah, TYRONEDAYBOO.
All right, I'm Lainey Melnick, and I will follow you. You can follow me.
Oh, lovely. Yeah, and ComedyRoneZone.com.
ComedyRoneZone. Okay, are you on Facebook?
Yep, Tyrone Hawkins on Facebook.
Hey, yeah. Awesome. He's funny.
Promo, I love it.
Thanks.
Feisty crowd in here tonight. How you guys doing? Yeah. We got some Journey fans in the house tonight.
Yeah. I went up to the midnight sun. Things go all around all night.
Snacks at Sorrento's.
Okay, well, we're in Galveston bright and early in the morning. I have a Lyft picking me up at 7:30, and I'll get to IAH Airport, Bush Airport, by probably 8:30, I think, for my flight to Miami, so I can board Norwegian Encore today. God, I'm so exhausted. One more trip. It's Sunday, means we're in Galveston.
All right, gangway this way, and all these people want their last Starbucks before we go. Last free Starbucks. Bye-bye. Bye, thank you.
Thank you so much for following, like, and subscribe, and follow me on all the social media networks, YouTube, TikTok. Don't miss a thing. Oh, there's a lot to come. You don't want to miss anything. So please like and subscribe. Above all, please let me help you book your next dream vacation. Thank you so much for following.